Hello, Joachim. You're head of the Investment Solutions Family Offices team at De Groof Petercam. Let's talk about family offices in this video today. How do they fit in a client's wealth management?
Good morning, Björn, and thank you for the question. So a family office, also called a family investment office, is an entity that creates a tailor-made investment strategy for a family. In doing so, we take into consideration all the various aspects and components of the family wealth. I mean by this that we take into consideration the financial portfolio at Bank A, but also at Bank B, Bank C, and so on and so forth. We will also take into consideration the various direct participations that a family might have, a family business, some startups, and also private equity funds, and so on and so forth. What is key and what differentiates us from other financial actors in the market is that we take into consideration all the various components of the family and that we use it to create a tailor-made investment strategy.
Family offices are on the rise. It's a growing segment within the financial sector. How can this growth be explained?
Indeed, it's true that family offices are really booming. It's a booming market, both in Belgium and abroad. Now, I see two main tailwinds for our sector. The first one is that there's a generation of entrepreneurs who are coming into the next phase of their wealth accumulation journey. I mean by this that they have been often very concentrated for a very long time into one asset and are now taking steps towards a more diversified approach to their patrimony. Now, this does not necessarily mean that they will completely sell the company. It often means that they have either taken an equity partner into the company, hence creating a cash event for the original entrepreneur, or that capital has simply flown from the company towards the private patrimony throughout the years. The second tailwind that we see is that wealthy families in general typically want to spread their assets over multiple counterparties. Now, this creates the need for an entity like a family office who can assist in finding these counterparties and managing all these various asset managers.
So this is an approach where you guide clients in both their asset management and their investment strategy. How do you do such a thing in practice?
Well, in practice, we always start by defining the objectives and wishes of the family. This can be, for instance, that the family wants to create a certain income stream out of the patrimony. Another example, certainly with cash events, is that there are certain projects that need to be financed. A third option that we regularly see is that the family is already thinking about passing on the fortune to the next generation, next to the typical risk and return objectives that we define. Now, once we have defined all these various objectives and wishes of the family, it's our job as a family office to translate that into what we call a master plan. Now, a master plan is also called an investment charter in more technical terms, and it will encompass items like an asset allocation, a private equity commitment strategy, liquidity needs, a cash flow prognosis, taking into consideration cash events in the future, and so on and so forth. So once we have agreed on the investment charter, the next phase is the implementation phase. Now, in this phase, we will go to the market and we will look for counterparties who can manage all the various buckets of wealth that we have defined in the master plan.
So we have single family offices, but there are also multi-family offices like you at De Groof Petercam. What is a multi-family office exactly?
So indeed, the term multi-family office stands in contrast to what we would call a single family office. Now, a single family office manages the wealth of one single family, hence the name single. On the other side, you have multi-family offices, like De Groof Petercam multi-family office, which are typically a bit larger teams who will create tailor-made investment strategies for multiple families.
Your team fulfills a coordinating role. How would you describe the collaboration with banks, asset managers, and companies invested in?
Well, the easiest way to look at it is to see a family office like an orchestra leader who leads a team of musicians experts. Now, the orchestra leader himself does not play an instrument, but he makes sure that all the musicians together play the music piece of the family in a beautiful, synchronized manner. Now, of course, each of the musicians is an expert at his instrument, but if you would leave each of them play the instrument in their own corner, it will not be beautiful, synchronized music together. And that is exactly the role of the family office. We are there to make sure that the objectives and the wishes of the family are translated to mandates for each of the different experts. In other words, we are there to make sure that the global objectives and constraints of the families are met.
Creating beautiful symphonies. Thank you very much, Joachim.
Welcome.